Welcome to a short lesson on solving one-step equations. The goals of this video are to determine if a given value is a solution to an equation and also to solve one-step equations. Let's begin by talking about the solution of an equation. Any replacement for the variable that makes an equation true is called a solution of the equation. So for example, x equals 3 is a solution to the equation 5x minus 4 equals 11, because if we replace x with 3, it makes this equation true, which means if I rewrite this as 5 times 3 instead of 5 times x minus 4 equals 11, if I simplify the left side, 15 minus 4 equals 11, and of course 15 minus 4 is 11. So 11 equals 11 is true, therefore x equals 3 is a solution. To solve an equation means to find all of its solutions. Okay, let's take a look at some ideas that we'll develop now to solve equations. First is the addition principle. For any real numbers a, b, and c, a equals b is equivalent to a plus c equals b plus c. So the idea here is if we have two numbers that are equal to each other, let's just say 3 equals 3, if we add the same number to both sides of the equation, it will still be a true statement. So if we added 2 to both sides of the equation, it would still be true because we'd have 5 equals 5. Now, notice it only says addition, but of course we could add a negative, which would be the same as subtracting a number on both sides. The next principle is the multiplication principle. Again, for any real numbers a, b, and c, where c is not equal to 0, a equals b is equivalent to a times c equals b times c. So if we start with the same idea where we know 3 is equal to 3, and then we multiply both sides of the equation by the same value, we can see it's still a true statement, 6 is equal to 6. So we're allowed to add or subtract a number from both sides of the equation, and we're also allowed to multiply or divide both sides of the equation by the same value, and it will maintain equality. So the goal of solving an equation is to isolate the variable on one side of the equation by using these principles. So let's go ahead and give it a try. Now, even though we could probably solve some of these mentally, we do want to develop the habit of showing the correct steps to solve an equation. So on problem number 1, we have x minus 8 is equal to negative 12. We know when we finish to have the variable isolated, we should have x equals some number on the right. So what we're thinking here is we really don't want this minus 8 here. So to undo minus 8, we would have to add 8. And if we add 8 to the left side of the equation, we must add 8 to the right side of the equation as well. Now we simplify. Notice when we add down minus 8 plus 8, that would simplify to 0. So we have x isolated on the left. Then on the right, negative 12 plus 8 equals negative 4. Therefore, our solution is x equals negative 4. And if we wanted to check this, we could replace x with negative 4. Negative 4 minus 8 is equal to negative 12, and it checks. On number 2, notice the variable y is on the right side of the equation. It doesn't matter which side the variable is on, as long as we isolate it. So when we finish, we should have some number equal to y. So again, we take a look at our equation, and notice that we don't want y plus 23, we just want y. So to undo plus 23, we'll subtract 23 on the right side and the left side. Now I could have added a negative 23 instead, but to me it's easier to see these are opposites, and therefore we'll add to 0. So now we'll simplify, we're left with y on the right side, and the left side at negative 6 minus 23 would equal negative 29. Therefore, our solution is y equals negative 29. And if we wanted to, we could rewrite this. So the variable is on the left side, but as you can see, these two are equivalent. Okay, on number three, we have a fraction involved, but the process is going to be identical. Notice that x is on the left. When we finish, we want x equal to some value. So we are going to have to undo plus 1/2. So we'll subtract 1/2 on both sides. So the plus 1/2 minus 1/2 simplifies to 0. We have x equals 7 minus 1/2 would be 6 1/2. Again, we can check this. 6 1/2 plus 1/2 is equal to 7. That's correct. And number 4, the z is on the left side. So when we finish, we want z equals some value. Now this one may look a little more confusing. We see a plus sign here, but then we have a negative. So it is attached by addition. So you may think we have to subtract, but what you have to subtract is a negative 3 minus a negative 3 actually ends up being plus 3. So in this problem, we need to add 3 to both sides. Another way to think of this is to undo a negative 3, we have to add 3. Either way, the result of negative 3 plus 3, that simplifies to 0, and that's what we wanted. We have z isolated, and on the right side we have 15 plus 3, which equals 18. Let's take a look at a few more one-step equations. Our first equation, we have 5x equals 75. It's important that we remember that 5x really means 5 times x is equal to 75. So if our goal is to isolate the variable, we need to undo this multiplication. Well, the opposite of multiplication is division. So to isolate this variable, we need to divide by 5 on both sides of the equation. Now you may think, how does this apply to the multiplication principle? But what you could think is multiplying by 1/5 is the same as dividing by 5. So when we simplify this, we will have 5 over 5 is 1. 1 times x is x. And 75 divided by 5 equals 15. So we have x equals 15. On number 2, let's rewrite this as negative 15 is equal to, now negative t is the same as negative 1 times t. This might be helpful because then we can see that in order to isolate this variable t, we will have to undo this multiplication, and so we'll divide by negative 1. Now the reason we're dividing by a negative 1 instead of just 1, remember we want t, not negative t. So when we simplify this, negative 1 divided by negative 1 gives us 1. So we have a t on the right side. Negative 15 divided by negative 1 equals positive 15. On number 3, the way we can read this, we have m divided by negative 4 is equal to 11. The opposite of dividing by negative 4 would be to multiply by negative 4. So we'll multiply the left side by negative 4. I'll put this over 1, since this is in fraction form. And on the right side, I will multiply by just negative 4. Now, even though these aren't in the same order, remember multiplication is commutative. So now we simplify. Negative 4 over negative 4 simplifies to 1m, which gives us just m. And 11 times negative 4 equals negative 44. And there's our solution. Here's one more. Remember, our goal is to have y equals some number. So if we have 2/3 y is equal to 16, what could we multiply this by to get 1y? Well, we could multiply it by its reciprocal. Notice if we do this, the 3s simplify and the 2s. So we'll multiply both sides by 3/2. So on the right side, we have our y. And on the left side, this does simplify. There's 1 factor of 2 in 2. And there's 8 factors of 2 in 16. Looks like we have 3 times 8, which is 24, over 1, which is just 24. Thank you for watching.